As you may know, Elon Musk recently acquired 100% of Twitter, and I want to show you one of his latest breaking tweets where he's saying that native Home Assistant Twitter integration will be one of the things that he's going to do. And this tweet is totally not photoshopped. Okay, it is photoshopped, and there is a working Home Assistant Twitter integration already, and I'm going to show you how to activate it and how to use it in this video. Watch this video till the very end to see how you can test this integration and how you can use it in automations. Before we continue further, here are some prerequisites to make this Home Assistant Twitter integration to work. First, you need a working Home Assistant. And second, you also need a Twitter account. One easy way to check if your Twitter account is working properly is to follow me. If you succeed, then everything is fine and you can proceed further. You will need a Twitter developer account. To get one, just go to developer.twitter.com and apply for one. It is free and the procedure is not hard at all. After that, log in with the Twitter developer account in the Twitter developer portal. And you should see a similar dashboard when you can create a project. But I don't need a project, I need a Twitter app. And for that, I'll click this button right here. Then overview, and then on create app button to create a new app. I have to pick a name here. For example, Home Assistant Twitter app. And then I'll click next. And now I have a Twitter app. I'll copy this API key and API secret and I'll store them somewhere safe. And then I'll go to the app settings. Under this user authentication settings, I'll click on this setup button and I'll enable this OAuth 1.0a switch. I'll select a read and write and direct message option here. And for callback and website URL, I should type something. For example, twitter.com. It doesn't matter actually. But these fields are not optional and I have to enter something. And I think I'm done. I'll click save. Changing permissions might affect your app. Yes, I'm okay with that. Now I'll scroll up a bit and I'll click on this keys and tokens tab. And next to access token and secret, I'll click on generate button. I'll copy these tokens as well, because I'll need them in my Home Assistant configuration. Okay, I saved both of the tokens and I can now freely click yes, I saved them. And with that, I'm ready with this Twitter developer portal. And now I'll go to my Home Assistant where I'll use these tokens. We are done with the Twitter keys generating part. Now it is time to add these keys in the Home Assistant configuration.yaml file. Here is what you have to do. Okay, this is my test Home Assistant installation. It is Home Assistant OS installation type, as you can see here from this label. But this same procedure will work on Home Assistant Container, Home Assistant Supervisor, and Home Assistant Core. Because I have add-on store here on this Home Assistant OS, I will use this add-on file editor to edit my configuration.yaml file. If you are using Home Assistant Container or Home Assistant Core, you should find your configuration.yaml file and just edit it with any text editor. Okay, this is my configuration.yaml file. I will paste these lines right here. Notify section with a name. The notify name will be Twitter. Platform is Twitter. Consumer key. These were my consumer key. I copied them immediately when I create this Home Assistant Twitter app. So I'll just paste the customer key right here. Of course, I can use the secrets.yaml file, which is more elegant and secure way, but just for the demo, I'll paste all of my credentials right here. That's my consumer key. That is my consumer secret. For the access token and access token secret, I'll use these tokens that I get from this regenerate button, if you remember. My access token, and this is my access token secret. Now, if I leave this configuration as it is now, when I use this notify service within my Home Assistant, I'll tweet a tweet on my Twitter feed. That means all notifications that are coming from Home Assistant using this notify service will go to my feed, and everyone that follows me on Twitter will see them. If I wish to use direct messages instead, I just have to add one more line. Username and my Twitter username. This is my Twitter handler. I think I'm ready. I just have to save the configuration and then I have to restart my Home Assistant. Time to quickly test if the Home Assistant Twitter integration is working as expected, and then we will put this in Home Assistant automation. Okay, Home Assistant has started and I can test if my Home Assistant Twitter notification is working. And to quickly check this, I'll use the developer tools, services. Of course, after that, I'll create an automation. But for now, I think this is the fastest way to check if Home Assistant Twitter notification is working. I'll search for Twitter here. Here it is. Notify.twitter notification is available. And I'll have to change this YAML a bit. I'll type message colon and then the message that I want to receive. Test Home Assistant Twitter message, for example, and I'll click on call service. Okay, green sign, that is fine. I'll open a new tab and I'll type twitter.com and I'll go to my messages section. Here it is. This is my test Home Assistant Twitter message. It is received successfully. Very good. Let's create an automation now. Before I'll show you how to create Home Assistant Twitter automations, I want to share what I did to help you further in your smart home journey. I've put together a glossary that have a very original name. It is called the Smart Home Glossary, and I want to give it to you absolutely free. Inside this glossary, you'll find the most important smart home words, abbreviations, and acronyms. Each item will have a simple but useful and understandable description. You can instantly download that glossary at automatelike.pro/glossary. Now, let's see that Home Assistant Twitter automation in action. I'll open the Home Assistant graphical editor and I'll create a new empty automation. The name of the automation will be Home Assistant Twitter Test Automation. The trigger, for example, will be the state of one of my smart Shelly bulbs. Here it is. Currently it is off. So I'll change this to state. The entity will be Shelly bulb do. And I want the state on, for example, 5 seconds. So when this Shelly bulb do becomes on for 5 seconds, execute this action. The action will be called service. The service will be notify Twitter. Here it is. And as message, I'll type your bulb is left on for 5 seconds. This is just an example. You can increase this value here and make this automation actually useful. But it doesn't matter for the demo. I'll just click save. And my automation is ready. Now, if I turn on my Shelly bulb do for 5 seconds, I should receive a notification. Here it is, your bulb is left on for 5 seconds. And because of Home Assistant, Twitter, Elon Musk, and this beautiful automation, everything is working just great. Hope that Elon Musk will not buy Home Assistant next. As well. The way it is now is the best. I also hope that this video was useful for you. If so, I'll see you next week when I will release my new video. I'm Kirill and I'm done speaking. Bye!